Do subscribe to Ekeeda channel and press bell icon to get updates about latest engineering, HSE and IIT JEE main and advanced videos.
As we have initially have learned a lot about the molar conductivity, and it says that it depends on the number of moles of a solution of an electrolyte from which electricity can be passed. So it depends on the number of moles, or it depends on the one mole of a solution that is present in the solution. That is one mole of the electrolyte that is present in the solution. So when we are going to learn about the molar conductivity, we have got to know that it increases with dilution. So when it is increased, then it is that for sure that the concentration has been decreased and the volume of the solution has been increased. So because of which the cations and anions are being dissociated, and hence the molar conductivity will increase. So since the cations and anions are being separated with each other, this is more possible in strong electrolytes. So strong electrolytes have the tendency to dissociate completely, and hence this has a chance to increase the molar conductivity. So if I could say that if concentration increases, then the molar conductivity decreases and vice versa. But when I say that when a strong electrolyte is being used, then for strong electrolytes, the degree of dissociation, or I could say they dissociate completely, and because of which the number of ions are separated much more effectively rather than for a weak electrolyte. So because of which this leads to a maximum value of the molar conductance that is represented by lambda naught, or that is also known as limiting value or maximum limiting value. So this is the value that is being approached when the conductivity, that when the molar conductivity is at infinite. So this is the molar conductivity that is being approached when the solution is at infinite dilution. Or in this case, if I would mention that the molar conductivity of the strong electrolyte is being approached till the limiting value. But when we talk about for a weak electrolyte, the conductivity, the molar conductivity also increases with decrease in the concentration, or I could say with increase in the dilution. But the limiting value, that is lambda naught, is not being reached that much as the strong electrolyte is being reaching, or we will get the limiting value for a strong electrolyte. So these are the two differences. That is, for weak electrolyte, we cannot determine, or the value will not match up with the limiting value of a strong electrolyte. So therefore, these are the two differences between a strong electrolyte and weak electrolyte. So therefore, I could say that the molar conductivity for a strong electrolyte will be maximum than that for a weak electrolyte. So these were the two variations from which we have determined that the strong electrolyte will have a good limiting value, whereas a weak electrolyte will have a lesser limiting value than the strong electrolyte. So thank you friends for watching this video. I hope you have got to know that what are the variations of molar conductivity that is shown by strong electrolyte as well as for a weak electrolyte. We are going to learn more about it in the next lecture. So till then, share this video with your friends and don't forget to subscribe Ekeeda channel. Thank you so much.